Morning students of class 10, we have started ratio and proportion exercise 4B. Question number 7C. In question number 7, find the third proportional of the following. Third proportional is asked. While two quantities are given. In question number C, these two quantities are x by y plus y by x. This is the first quantity and second quantity is x by y. We are asked to find out the third proportional. For that I wrote here, let the third proportional be A. Here we can't consider x because x is given already in the question. As given, what happens now, we will prepare the order of this proportion. X by y plus y by x is 2, x by y equal to, this term will be repeated, x by y is 2, this is the place of third proportional A in the continued proportion. This is the continued proportion, this is the place of third proportion. And this term will be repeated. I repeated it both sides. Now, here LCM became xy. So, numerator will be, I divided this LCM by this denominator y. So, x is left, x into x, x square, plus came here. Again, I divided this LCM by this denominator x. We got y into y, y square is 2, x by y equal to x by y is 2a. Now, x square plus y square by xy is 2x by y means x square plus y square by xy by x by y. So y, this will be reciprocal. We can write in this way, x square plus y square by xy into reciprocal of this will be y by x. Y will go up, x will come down. Equal to this 2 will be x by y by a means this will be x by y into a, x by ay. So here y cancelled. What is left? X square plus y square by this x into x, x square equal to this side x by ay. So a equal to this, a equal to x square into x, x cube by y into x square plus y square. That is the third proportional. In question number 8a, given that B is the mean proportional of A and C. And then we are asked to prove A is to C. A, C, A square, B square, C square, all these four quantities are proportional. If these four quantities are proportional, then we can write A is to C equal to A square plus B square is to B square plus C square. Now, proof, as it is given, B is the mean proportional of A and C, so we can write B square equal to AC. Now, A square plus B square equal to A square plus AC. At the place of B square, I kept the value of B square, that is AC. So from these two, I have taken A as common. So inside the bracket, A plus C. Again, B square plus C square equal to, I kept the value of B square, that is AC. AC plus C square. From these two, I have taken C common. Inside the bracket, A plus C is left. Now, A square plus B square is to B square plus C square. The fractional form of this expression is A square plus B square by B square plus C square. A square plus B square, the value is A into A plus C, and the value of B square plus C square is C into A plus C. So A plus C cancelled, A by C is left, we can write A is to C. So what are the thing? From this calculation, we are coming to LHS. Therefore, LHS equal to RHS, hence I wrote here, A is to C equal to A square plus B square is to B square plus C square, proved. In question number 8C, B is the mean proportional of A and C, and we are asked to prove AB plus BC plus CA by A plus B plus C whole cube equal to ABC. Since B is the mean proportional of A and C, so I wrote here let A by B equal to B by C equal to K. This is the mean proportional, so this will come in continued proportion, B will be repeated. For that I have repeated here B, A by B equal to B by C equal to K. Then I got the value A equal to BK, B equal to CK by cross multiplication, A equal to BK, B equal to CK. Here again, A equal to, the value of B is CK, so I kept here CK, CK into K, CK square. So the values of A is CK square and B is CK. Now, LHS is AB plus BC plus CA by A plus B plus C whole cube. I have kept the values A equal to CK square into B equal to CK plus BC. B is CK into this C is C plus CA, C into A, the value of A is CK square, I wrote here, by A plus B plus C, the value of A is CK square plus the value of B is CK plus the value of C is C, bracket closed, whole cube. Now, I multiplied it, c into c, c square, k square into k, k cube, plus c into c, c square, k, plus c square, k square, by c k square plus c k plus c whole cube. Now, from these three terms, we can take c square k common. What is left? Here k square is left, here 1 is left, and here k is left. I closed inside the bracket. And from these three terms, we can take c common. So what is left? K square plus k plus 1 is left. I closed in the bracket. So these three terms and these three terms are same. I cut it. What is left? C square k by c. This c and this square is also cancelled. Ck is left. When ck will come out with the cube, then it will be c cube k cube. Now I took RHS. RHS is ABC. I kept the value of a, that is ck square, value of b into ck, value of c is c only. So I multiplied this 3c, c cube, k square into k, k cube. Therefore, LHS equal to RHS proved. After question number 8, few questions, 3 questions are there. Question number 9, question number 10, question number 11. Those are based on application. Those are not in our syllabus. Now we come to the properties of ratio and proportion. There are few properties such as invertendo property, alternando property, componendo property, dividendo property, convertendo property, and componendo dividendo property. And last is equivalent ratio property. So this invertendo property states that if A is to B proportional to C is to D, then B is to A is proportional to D is to C. How is it true? Let us see. It is given A is to B proportional to C is to D, means these four quantities are in proportional. So I wrote here A is to B proportional to C is to D. I wrote the fractional form of this A by B. The symbol of proportional to is equal to, and the fractional form of C is to D is C by D. Then I wrote the inverse of this A, B, C and D, because the rule of the name of property is invertendo, inverse of this quantity we will write. Inverse of A is 1 by A, inverse of B is 1 by B, inverse of C is 1 by C, inverse of D is 1 by D. So all these four quantities will also remain in proportional. Suppose now 1 by A, this symbol is changed, the symbol of multiplication. Now we have to write the inverse of this, B will go up, 1 will come down. Similarly, 1 by C into this symbol is changed to into, then we have to write the inverse of this, so D will go up, 1 will come down. It became B by A equal to D by C. I wrote in the form of ratio and proportion, B is to A proportional to D is to C. This symbol of proportional to is coming from the symbol of equal to. The second property is alternando property. If A is to B proportional to C is to D, then A is to C proportional to B is to D. How does it happen? I have taken this A is to B proportional to C is to D. I wrote the fractional form A by B equal to C by D. Then I did cross multiplication AD equal to BC. We can write this as A by C equal to B by D. Because if you do cross multiplication, you will get back this. A into D, AD, B into C, BC. So we can write this as A by C equal to B by D. Now I wrote these fractions in the form of ratio and proportion. A is to C proportional to B is to D. Time. Today I have completed two properties of ratio and proportion, alternando property and invertendo property. Invertendo property and alternando property. Few more properties are left. You will see those properties in the next video class. Thank you for watching the video.